Now, your KSBW weather forecast with meteorologist Gina DeVecchio.
Let's take a look at all of those storm reports across the state. Look at that snowfall. All those little circles are showing where we've been seeing accumulating snowfall, reports of feet of snow, in addition to feet of snow that we've already had up there. Here you can see as we zoom in, it's a little difficult to see, but you can check out those little dots there. Those are flood reports as well as wind reports in much of our region. And taking a look, you can see all of those that we had, some high winds. Earlier in the show, we talked about those wind gusts. We're going to see those dying down a bit tonight, but instead of the 50 and 60 mile per hour wind gusts, we're going to be seeing 30 to 40. So still pretty strong and saturated grounds. So here you can see these impressive totals. Here's what I'm talking about. Over 8 inches, 8.7 inches in the last 24 hours. So earlier in the show, we talked about the storm totals. These totals are just from 4 o'clock yesterday to 4 o'clock today. Look at that. Over 5 inches in many locations or near five in the Santa Cruz Mountains, Scotts Valley, 2.23. So still a good amount there, a healthier amount. All of this water is going to have to run off into the Santa Cruz area where they picked up 3 inches, 3.5, and then Capitola and Aptos seeing that as well. Taking a look inland, you can see even heavy rain in Gilroy, Morgan Hill, over an inch. Hollister, a little bit of a rain shadow there at only about a half of an inch. Moss Landing, near an inch of rainfall, and then down the Salinas Valley, little rain shadow as that system moved in from the south, southeast over the mountains. And the mountains, those were the bullseyes. That's where we picked up over 7 inches in some areas south of Big Sur. Big Sur itself, 2.02. And then you can see the Monterey Peninsula kind of got the short end of the stick today, but you know what? That's okay. That's a good amount, about a half of an inch in Monterey. And also that's where we had some of the strongest winds. So we also had some power outages in that area earlier today. That is going to be a possibility once again tonight as we do see these gusty winds. Here you can see right now some heavy rainfall about to approach the Big Sur area. Once again, that's going to make its way over the mountains and then probably get cut off a bit as it heads towards Soledad in the Salinas Valley, but still going to be seeing that rainfall. So we are going to see consistent rainfall throughout tonight and some pockets of heavy rainfall. But let's get to tomorrow morning for the morning commute, where it looks like, yes, we'll have light rain. Be prepared for that. Still some winds coming in. But we'll start the day with some pockets of heavy rainfall possible. But then throughout the day, the bulk of that should stay south of us. So this means lighter showers, meaning that it will be easier for travel. And then as we go into Tuesday, looks like maybe some more scattered showers. These ones could be a little bit on the heavier side, but looking like that'll kind of be the tail end of this first system. Then we have another system on the way for this upcoming weekend. We're going to take a look at that over the next few days and really pinpoint that system for you. But as of right now, we are holding on to chances of showers. I think there's going to be a little break Wednesday afternoon into Thursday, but I just kept those rain symbols in there because it looks like it could rain for a portion of those days, but not as much, hence the little bit of sunshine peeking out. Right. Share your holiday, a big event here at the station, and that looks like it is going to be a possibly wet one, so we'll keep a close eye on that.
Dan, Aaron, the rest of the gang, they'll probably have ponchos, umbrellas out there.
Ponchos we have, exactly, and we have tents and right. everything. And this isn't looking like it's going to be as windy of a storm because tents in the rain, not a good idea.
No.
But yeah, I think it'll be just fine and get you in the holiday spirit because the weather sure feels like winter.
Very much so, mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you, Gina.